So I remember as an intern, in the back of my head, I had this idea that I wanted to do laboratory research. I'd really enjoyed it previously. I'd spent almost 2 years in Dr. Wapner's lab beforehand. But I kind of didn't know anything beyond then, or beyond that, I guess, when I went into it. And when I was an intern, I started talking to different kind of chiefs whosever service I was on and asking what they did. And I think one of the neat things about our program is that people do such like a wide variety of different things during their PD years. And so I asked different chiefs, and one of the chiefs that I had been in the Longacre Laboratory and really had amazing things to say about it, and it sounded like a good fit. So he sent an email, and I got to meet with Dr. Longacre, and it seemed like exactly what I was looking for. And pretty kind of soon within that time period, I heard about the arts program, which is a chance to do a PhD during the professional development years. And so I applied for that because I'd always toyed with this idea of doing a PhD, and this just seemed like a really great time to do it. And I was thrilled to be accepted into the arts program and into the cancer biology PhD training program. The program was extremely supportive of me taking on this opportunity, even though it kind of put a wrench in the plan potentially just for numbers and stuff. But Dr. Hahn actually sat down with me and Dr. Longacre very early on and was really encouraging of me to take on this thing. And I kind of never felt negative pressure in that regard. So I'm super grateful to her and to Dr. Melcher and Dr. Spain throughout. Obviously, the PhD has been a great experience to validate that I really want research to be part of my life going ahead, which is what I was hoping I would come out with. And then also just like making it be possible to actually have that experience. I think there's a lot of kind of, particularly with laboratory research, there's concern of how will I balance it and how will this play out. And I'm really glad to say that I feel like my PhD experience has made it seem more possible to do those things, to kind of be both a researcher and a surgeon rather than less possible. So I'm pleased that I've come out the other end with the possibility that it's really gonna hopefully work out for me to be able to maintain both of those things. That was a great time both to kind of begin to learn some of these research skills, but it's also a great time to get to see your friends and kind of catch up on where everyone is, because research can be a lot more isolating than being a clinical resident, so it's really nice to have kind of a forum where we get to come together and eat lunch and complain about things and stuff like that. So that was awesome. And I think the leadership seminars, similarly, it's been great to watch that program really take off in the last few years. I think Dr. Korndorfer is really bringing a unique piece to our training that we wouldn't otherwise have received. And it's great. I mean, I think it's a terrific opportunity for us. Again, similarly, a forum in which we can come together as a kind of a group of research residents and share what's going on, but also kind of reflect a little more meaningfully on our training experiences in terms of what does it take to like become an effective attending and a leader in research and in those regards. Just to put a plug for basic science, I think that it can often be something that kind of people aren't sure about. It certainly takes a lot of time and a lot of physical time in the lab, but I can say that it's been a really rich experience to be able to do basic science at this point in my career and really indulge in that awesomeness. I also think one of the amazing things about the labs at Stanford is they are so close to the hospital, and that's not the case everywhere. So I think that's something really to keep in mind with the thought of maybe if you're thinking you maybe want to spend some time in the lab, it's really feasible here in that, it takes me 5 minutes to go to the OR to pick up a specimen. And so it really makes the translational component of basic science research really actually pragmatically feasible and a really rich experience rather than kind of spending too much time being frustrated with logistics or something. I also think that the fact that we have such extraordinary basic science laboratories within the Department of Surgery really allows that, kind of makes a seamless integration between being a clinical resident and being able to be a researcher. So Dr. Longacre is, of course, a surgeon. There's other surgeons in the certainly in plastic surgery, but in the department in general, who really have dedicated their careers to basic science research. And I think that experience is so unique to really to be able to be in a lab and have people understand where I am in my training in a meaningful way, and just being able to interface with like cancer biology department, which is much more kind of basic science, and like full clinical surgery in a way that really allows that kind of a seamless integration. So that's my plug for basic science. I continue to be enthusiastic about it, and I think it's really brings a unique perspective to clinical surgery. The other thing I did during my PD years was I had a child. I felt really supported by the department in starting a family. And you know, I think all of these, as a woman in surgery, all of these things kind of happen in our lives at the same time. And I'm really grateful to be at a place where I'm supported to do all those things at once. Like, I think I wrote my F32 like a couple days. I finished it a couple days after I had my baby. So having all of those things for me, having all of those things happening at once in my life is like exactly where I would like to be. So, and I'm glad that the department can kind of encourage all of it to be at the same time. I think one of the challenges with surgical training is that we spend all this time in the lab and then we go back to clinical for so long, and it's really hard to kind of pick everything back up potentially 5 years later when the technologies have changed. And I think that's one of the reasons that people can be discouraged from doing it as an attending. So I'm really hoping that I can keep things going enough while I'm clinically busy, and really be able to maintain kind of the thought process that I've been going through with my research, to hopefully keep doing it as a big kid when I finally grow up.